Greetings for the day, guys. Now in this session we will be discussing about graphical convolution, right? So what our aim here is, whatever we have solved till date using mathematical formulations and all, our aim here is to visualize the actual process of convolution. See, in the class, in the webinars, I already discussed that if there is a picture outside, that is, suppose that some kind of picture is there and you want to view that particular picture through a window, right? So what in order to have the complete view of that picture, what you are required to do is you are required to slide this window over this particular picture from its starts to the end. So this particular thing is nothing but shifting that the other function by an amount of t. Already we had enough discussion about why this minus lambda is required, why we are required to flip that signal and then shift, right? That's why we come with t minus lambda, or otherwise it is minus lambda plus t. Already enough discussion has been done there regarding this thing, right? So my aim here was just to introduce you people that okay, we are having this picture. This particular picture needs to be viewed through this window, and this window needs to be slided over, rolled over through the entire length of the picture. And that is nothing but, and whatever is face to face impact of this sliding, we will be, what I can say is, we will be better able to comment on the view that we could see from this window, and that comment is nothing but the output response. And in that sense, that output response is given by this y of t, wherein it is x of t convolved with h of t, right? So all the formulations are known to us earlier, hence I'll not be elaborating those formulations here, right? Now, in this particular problem, we are required to convolve u of t with this particular signal. Now, the very basic step that needs to be addressed here is, first of all, whatever are the signals given, let us try to draw these signals. And then try to perform folding, shifting, and multiplication, or that integration, right? So that kind of things we'll be doing with these signals. So let us focus towards the first thing, that is nothing but drawing this signal, okay? So when I want to draw this signal, it's quite very easy to draw this one. Hence, that means the first signal. Hence, I have drawn this first signal here as x of t is equals to u of t. I know that u of t is equals to 1 for all the values of t which are greater than 0. Hence, I have drawn this particular thing there. Now, the tricky point of the story is, I need to focus on this part. So if I focus on this second signal, which is my impulse response, in that case I can easily see that okay, so this particular signal is made up of two parts. One is t minus 1 and the other one is t minus 3, right? And both of these parts are scaled by a factor 3. So I need to better draw this particular thing. We know that u of t is equals to, I need to change the pen color. Okay, fine. U of t is equals to 1 for all the values of t which are greater than or equal to 0. So u of t minus 1, I'm very sorry for this thing. U of t minus 1, here it comes to be t minus 1 is equals to 0, so t is equals to 1. That's why the signal will start from 1, right? But at the same time, it is scaled by a factor of 3. Hence, earlier, if the value of u of t is 1, now it becomes 3. And hence, I am able to draw my signal like this. Now, secondly, move ahead, wherein in the second part of my story of the signal, what I am required to do is, I am required to draw this signal. I'm required to draw this signal wherein it is u of t minus 3. So t minus 3 is equals to 0. Now comes to be t is equals to 3. So the signal will start from t is equals to 3, right? And t is equals to 3, the signal is starting from t is equals to, you can very well see here, at the same time this part also is multiplied with this 3, hence it is scaled with a factor 3. Now, is my job done? No, my job is not done. Why? Because this signal is, it is subtracted, the second part of the signal, the second part of the signal is subtracted from the earlier one. So I need to focus on the subtraction also. Let us see what happens in the subtraction is, for this much of the part, for till 1, both the signals are not present. So obviously the resultant signal also will not be present. While when my signal goes from 1, goes ahead from 1, what is happening here? Here the signal is having a value 3. Here this particular signal from 1 to 3, it is not present. So the value of the signal up to this much of the part will be 3 minus 0. So that is equals to 3, right? 3 minus 0, that is equals to 3. Hence from 1 to 3, my signal is having a value 3. What is happening after this is, see, after 3, this signal also is present and this signal also is present, and both of them are having a value 3. So 3 minus 3, my signal is becoming 0. So no signal is present after this and no signal is present in this duration. So the representation of my signal is only from 1 to 3, that too also with an amplitude 3. Okay, with an amplitude 3. My equation of the story, my equation of convolution now becomes y of t is equals to minus infinity to infinity x of t minus lambda into h of lambda d lambda. Still, we have not focused upon this infinity kind of thing, right? Before I go ahead with this, I know that one of the signal is flipped and shifted. Convolution is commutative. Either of the signal can be flipped or shifted, or anyone, x1 can be flipped or shifted, or h also can be flipped and shifted. So both way it is doing the same thing. Whether that, for this particular thing I have given one example in class, like suppose you want to observe this picture through this window, either you scroll this picture through this window till its complete length, or you roll this window through this picture for its entire length. Ultimately the result will be same. So I'm moving ahead. Now what I need to know is both of these signals are available to me. This signal is also there with me and this signal is also there with me. Both of them are there, right? See, again I'm telling you, this one is also there and this one is also there. Now what I will do is, this signal is also there with me. I'm very sorry, I've given a step ahead. This signal is also available with me and this signal is also available there with me. Now what I will do is, I will flip this signal and shift it. I will keep this as it is, while the flipping and shifting operation I will carry out with this signal. So first of all, let me flip it. If I flip this signal, I've lost my PDF. Just a minute, I'm getting back. Okay, fine. Sorry for that interruption. Now, what I'll do is, I'll flip this signal, right? If I flip this, whatever was present here on the positive side of my x-axis will now be available at the negative side, right? Now, it's just a business of flipping. Now, I need to shift it. Let me say that I'll be shifting this flipped signal with a shifting factor t. Right now, I don't know how much is the value of this t. It's a generic thing, right? I don't know whether it is 1, 2, 5, 7, whatever it is, I don't know right now. So, What I will do is, I'll simply flip and shift this thing, and merely a general notation I will give it as t. So I don't know on this axis at what moment of t it is shifted, right? Now, the next part of the story is, we are required to bring both the signals in the same window, in the same plane, right? We need to bring them face to face. Then only we can see the operation, right? So what I will do is, I'll be getting both of them together on the same axis. So here, this is my x of minus lambda plus t, right? It is x of minus lambda plus t, or t minus lambda, whatever you can say, you can call it as x of t minus lambda. And this is nothing but 3 into u of t minus 1 minus 3 into u of t minus 3. So both of them are there now on the same plane, right? Now what happens in this case is, see, if the value of my shift, here this shift is shown by t, if that value of my shift t lies in between 0 to 1, what I can see? I can see that both the signals are not overlapped, right? Picture ek jagah pe hai and window ek jagah pe hai. How you'll be able to see the picture and comment on the result? It will not be possible. It is next to impossible in that case to comment on that scenery, right? So in that case, I'll say that as in this particular range, when my t is there from 0 to 1, there is hardly overlap, hardly that overlap. Hence, the value of the convolution becomes 0, right? Now, let us move ahead, wherein I'll be shifting the signal with the other value of the t, and now that value of my t falls in the range from 1 to 2. This t is now rolled over, right? It is moving. You can see, guys, this was earlier between 0 to 1. Now it is coming between 1 to 2, right? So the signal is rolled over. Now, when my value of t comes here, when my signal x of t comes here in this particular range, I can see that there is a overlap in between these two signals, but this overlap only is there from 1 to t, right? This overlap is not visible, is not there for other values of t which are greater, for other values which are greater than t, right? So what could be the limit of integration here? Can you think? Yes, the limit of integration in this case is only the region of overlap. The region of overlap specifies the limit of integration, right? So here, the limit of my integration lies from 1 to t. The equation remains x of t minus lambda into h of lambda d lambda. From the region 1 to t, what is the value of x of t minus lambda? The value of x of t minus lambda is 1 because it is unit step. What is the value of h of lambda? Magnitude. It is 3, right? It is 3. Okay. So, I'll be writing it here as y of t is equals to 1 into 3 from the range 1 to t, right? And if I solve it, what I'm going to get is y of t is equals to 3 lambda. Upper limit is t and the lower limit is 1. Now, if I substitute the limits, upper limits and the lower limits, what I am going to get is y of t is equals to 3t minus 3. But this is the half truth, right? This particular response is the response when my t lies in between the range 1 to 2, right? If I don't, again, let me come back to my window and say scene example. If I don't slide the window, if I see through the window only for the first instance, then what happens is I may not be able to see the house that is there beside to that tree, right? Because from that window, it is not possible to see that house. So what I can just comment is, okay, there is just merely a tree. But is that true? No, it's not true. Why? Because I have not slided over the window again till my picture ends. Till my picture ends. Hence, this is the half truth. Now, what we are required to do? I am required to shift this T. I am required. Just a minute. I am required to shift this T again from again here. Now my T lies in the range from 2 to 3. Now my T lies in the range from 2 to 3. Okay, let us move ahead. If my T lies in the range from 2 to T, my signal comes to be like this, 2 to 3. The signal is this and the overlap is this. However, now in this case, my signal limits are again from 1 to T. My signal limits are again from 1 to T. Again, my Y of T will be what? 3T minus 3. Now, again, this T is slided over. If it is slided over and it comes here in between 3 to 4 or whatever, if it is greater than T. Now, see, what is the overlap? In that case, the overlap will be from 1 to... In that case, the overlap will be from 1 to 3, right? Because in this region, there is no overlap. Let me draw it again very clearly. If my T moves, now shifted here. What will be the region of overlap of these two signals? This is the first signal. And let me change the color of my pen. And if this one is the right, and this is my second signal, what will be the region of overlap? The region of overlap will be this much, wherein both the signals come face to face. Okay, so the region of overlap is now only this much of the part, right, wherein both the signals are face to face with each other, right? So this is how the, now in this case wherein this my T is like this, wherein my T is like this, the overlap is from 1 to 3, the overlap is from 1 to 3, the value of the signal is 1 and 3, and let me calculate the limits. If I calculate the limits, in that case it becomes 3 lambda, upper limit is 3 and the lower limit is 1. If I solve it, I come across Y of T is equals to 6. Now, for the final convolution result, my output response will be Y of T is equals to 0 from 0, when my T is in between 0 to 1. Why? Because there was no overlap. If you could remember that thing, I'll draw it for you. See, this was the thing. It was like this and it was like this, right? Sorry, just a minute. I'll draw it for you again. Okay, fine. So here is the thing. This was my U of T minus 1 minus 3, U of T minus 3. Here also this thing was there. And here it was this thing wherein my T was less than 1. Here it is 3, right? Here it is 1. Okay, so when my signal was lying there, this particular T was in between 0 to 1. There was no overlap and that's why the convolution was 0. When my signal was lying there from, just a minute, from lying there, this was my 1, this was my 3, this was my T, this was my 2. When my signal was lying there in between, when my T was lying there in between 1 and 2, the overlap was only this much of the part. Hence, the limits of the integration were from 1 to T. Similar was the thing there when again my T has slided over. Again, my T has slided over 1 to 3. It is 2. Earlier it was here. Now if it slides here, the region of overlap becomes this much of the part. Again, the limits of the integration were from 1 to T. And we have obtained for that limit the answer as 3T minus 3. The same thing was there for this case also. The same thing is there for this case also, right? Now, what happened after this is, I got the answer as 6. Why? Because, see, Why? Because these two were the signals. This was the signal with 3 amplitude. This was the signal with 1, 3, and this is T. When my T was greater than 3, in that case, the region of overlap was only present from 1 to 3. Why? Because for this much of the part, one of the signal was not present. This particular signal is not present in this duration, no? So there was no overlap. And if I evaluate the convolution from the integration, within the integration limit 1, 2, 3, we come to the answer as 6. So for different instances or for the different ranges of T, different lying ranges of T, the value of the output response is different. Finally, we are going to get the cumulative response and we are going to display it like this. So, I feel the idea of graphical convolution is quite clear, right? In the next webinar, we will solve the other problem there. But guys, before I come up with the other problem there, I request all of you to go through this particular video very carefully. Why? Because we'll not be investing much more time on this particular thing in the next webinar. Good day, guys. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Take care.